Hey everybody, it's Drogeth here, and I am bringing you the third place matchup for the New England StarCraft Tournament number one that happened at Galaxy Gaming in Dover, New Hampshire. This is one of the newer maps. This is Delta Quadrant, and we have NE6 as the blue Zerg in the upper right-hand corner with our very favorite Krom, break and enter the green Zerg. Sadly enough, he won't be coming to the next tournament because he had to go back to Belgium. So, no more Conan jokes the next time I cast, I guess. Which kind of makes me sad, but you know. I really didn't like getting my butt whooped. Haha, but it's going to happen again. Anyways, Delta Quadrant. This was a new map for me. I've actually only played on it once. I ended up losing, just because there was so much going on. I got no excuse for losing, really. My harvester stopped harvesting, I never moved guys over, but that's enough about me. These two guys, like I said, this is the third place matchup. Break and Enter actually lost like his first map, and then just absolutely tore through the loser bracket to make it all the way to this spot where NE6 actually got a couple of wins and then got bumped down. I think he just lost to Alpha Fuzzer, Green Lantern, or Green Ranger. I think he just lost to him for some sort. I might be ruining some games later on, but these are the really important ones. He just lost to Green Lantern, got knocked down here. I'm gonna have to double check the maps on this, but as you can see, Break and Enter and NE6 doing some scouting. Minerals, as far as mineral goes, Break and Enter putting down a 13 pool, then right to his gas. And on the same side, we have, looks like we have almost mirrored builds, though NE6 looks like he might have gotten down his spawning pool just a little bit earlier. Crazy thing about this map, right in the middle, you have a Zelnaga watchtower, but it's covered in smoke with your gold expansions. Right here and right here in the middle, completely exposed. I don't want to say the natural expansion, because your natural expansion is actually blocked by rocks down here. Very easy base to defend. However, if somebody gets up here on the line, maybe some siege tank or bling stonkers, very painful. But your second expansion right out here in the front of your base is also exposed, and each one of these four positions has that exposed base. Now, another thing that we'll look at is if you're doing two players on this four-player map in particular, what you can do is you can end up, if you expand over to here and your opponent is right next to you, like on this one, we do have some Zergling movement. From NE6, we get some quick Zerg coming out, but if you do expand over into this area, and your opponent's here and you have them blocked in, you have free open access to these guys, and they're easily defended because the middle part is choked pretty easily. You do have these side paths, though they're not used as much. And we got some Zerglings coming in here, one queen, four Zerglings for defense. And looks like NE6 is going to micro around a little bit with his five Zerglings. I wonder where the sixth one is, probably making its way over there. But gonna try and take out this queen, gonna do some serious damage to these little Zerglings. Queens are great for defense, especially with the range that they have for close combat. Look at that, they stabbed him right at the end of the creep. As well as being able to block the ramp because it's a larger sized unit. So I'm gonna speed this up just a little bit because it seems like it's going extremely slow. And with two Zergs on the map, they're really taxing my video card. I even dropped the settings down just a little bit, but it looks like NE6 is falling away. And we do have, what is that? How did NE6 do that? He actually took his drone that he was scouting with and dropped it in here as a spine crawler. And he is causing some serious damage to these units, and he is finally going down there. The spine crawler goes down, and these guys can go back to resources. As we see a large amount of roaches pop out for Break and Enter. On the other side, we see still even more Zerglings coming with a Baneling nest, and somebody is actually knocking on my door, so I gotta pause this. Sorry about that. It was my neighbor at the door giving me mail that I don't want. you owe money, blah, blah, blah. Anyways, back to the action. We do have roaches moving across the board with these zerglings turning into banelings. Breakenender seeing this with the queen very close to the ramp. A secondary queen could do a perfect break for that ramp, but these banelings smashing into those roaches and completely collapsing, not being able to do very much damage. Oh man, those banelings looks really awesome in blue. But those banelings just crashing upon the roaches, and the roaches just looking at them like, what? I'm a roach. I can survive a nuclear holocaust. What are you going to do to me? So banelings not being of any use there. Spinecrawler going down for some type of defense, and it looks like NE6 is making even more banelings. I'm not sure if this is a wise move, seeing that it really didn't do too much damage. It did do some nice splash damage, but I'm not sure if that trade-off was very much worth it for those banelings. We do have an Evo Chamber going in the back, so it looks like we might be seeing Hydralisk pretty soon. But again, I don't think that those banelings were doing enough damage to really warrant using them against the roaches. But then again, maybe I missed out on some splash damage. You might be able to catch them off guard and blow them all up. Mwahahaha. We have missile attack being involved, so the level 1 attack for these roaches being increased. And look at this nice little wall right here. And we have a huge speedlings, and we've got the banelings. Speedlings in the front, banelings in the back. Speedlings might move in. Nope, look at that nice little spread over there. Going to make a nice little wall as if it was a Terran. And the banelings kind of mixing it up. Speedlings coming in, trying to poke and enter, see what's going on. Knows that they couldn't enter. Got to get those banelings in the front. And look at that. Could get a nice run by if Breakenender did not move in very quick enough. Some type of tech. Nope, we're readjusting, getting the banelings in the front. That speedling getting by and getting roasted by those by the other speedlings. Got no other tech going on right here. We just kind of have a Mexican stalemate right at the front door as Breakenender just starts amassing even more and more roaches. I gotta see if he's developing anything. NE6 is going for the spire. Very nice move by him, getting the anti-air getting the air units where Breakenender does not have any anti-air at all, except for the queen unit, and keeping out here every once in a while, testing the front door, making sure Breakenender stays back here. Oh, and he's starting to make a move out right now, and these roaches are going to be able to do some serious damage to those zerglings. Zerglings moving backwards, banelings trying to come in and crash the party, and look at that, 1, 2, 3, I think 6 of them charged into those roaches, were not able to do very much damage at all. Look at this. No roaches died in that cataclysmic clash of the Titans. And this Spinecrawler is the only real defense that Breakenender has until those Mutalisks are able to come out. And the Spire is not even up yet. So any type of delay, Spinecrawler taking some serious damage from those roaches. And the roaches are going to have free reign now that they are inside here. The Spire does go up. We see 2 mutas go down, but those mutas aren't going to be able to do much with all these drones. The roaches are just going to be able to plow in through here, and this queen may be able to cause some damage. Let's see what's happening. Too many health bars in there, but we do have some roaches going down very slowly. These drones doing very minimal damage. Very, very minimal damage. Let's see. 5 damage with the claws, but these guys got what type of armor? 1 armor, so 4. Only doing 4 damage a pop, and that's not much when it comes to the roach defense. Income-wise, NE6 is able to build something out, but he did get those mutas out. So if he can take out these 3 mutas with the roaches and still keep his army alive. In the meantime, though, we've got more roaches coming in over here. So I don't see... Oh, look at that! Those 3 right there. We have okay base going down, but look at these roaches. They're seeing the creep over here that's being pooped out by the creep tuners. The Mutalisk coming in, gonna try some damage. Hopefully, NE6 will be able to cancel this before it destroys. Get his minerals back, and no, that base goes down. So NE6 loses the game and checks out. So that's game 1 going to break and enter on the. Delta Quadrant map. So let's get ready and check out game number 2. So it's Draugith checking out.